folks. Clyde Lindsay here from Pixel Pro Displays. Thank you so much for taking the time to check out today's tips and tricks video. So, folks, I had a conversation with Keith the other day, and I was asking for the possibility of adding a functionality into X-Lights, and that functionality was, how about telling me how long the effect is that I have selected? And much to my chagrin, Keith told me, Clyde, that already exists. And so, folks, I'm here today to show you something that I learned about X-Lights within the past few days, within the past week or so, that should be something that's very helpful for you as you go about sequencing. So I have actually three things I'm going to show you today. The first one does have to do with the duration of an effect. And down here at the bottom of the screen, what you'll see, what you see here is a dialogue pops up here at the bottom, some words and so forth. But when you hover over or select an effect, you will notice that you have on the bottom right hand of that dialogue, it says 3.55 spirals. And what that stands for is the total duration of that effect in X-Lights where it's placed. Now, the numbers before it also denote where in the waveform when that effect physically starts and where that effect physically ends, the exact times that those effects start and stop. Now, some of that information may not be exactly useful, but the duration is very useful. And the reason why that duration is very useful is because when we're doing things such as transitions using our layers blending box, and I'll go up here and we'll pop it out. I use a lot of transitions in my sequencing because it adds a different layer to it. Now, whenever I talk about transitions, I'm talking about this in and out transition. Mostly people use the fade, and the way that we fade in or the way that we activate a physical transition in X-Lights is using a physical time. Well, what better way than to select a specific time than to know how long the duration of the physical effect is that we want to have that happen for. So I can look quickly now at the bottom of the screen and I can say, well, this spirals effect is 3.6 seconds long, and that means I have 3.6 seconds that I can start fading out or start my transition, and that anything longer than that is kind of a waste, because you'll end up throwing an error in your check sequence. It'll say there's a sequencing error in your effect because your duration of the transition is much longer than the duration of the effect itself. And thus, that's why I asked Keith the question, because I wanted to make sure that I didn't have any issues whenever I was using an effect and the duration of the fade or the duration of the transition was actually longer, because I wanted to avoid having those errors in my sequencing whenever I did a check sequence. Now, the truth of the matter is this number can be 6, and if that's the case, and you're looking at the all roof. So you can see that it's at 6 seconds, it's already halfway through its duration, and you're not getting anything of the effect in. But if you change it to 1, it's going to be on for quite a while. It's going to be on for 2 seconds and then start to fade out. So yes, it does work. It just creates an error in the check sequence. But I find this very useful whenever I need to do quick transitions. And I'm not going to cover transitions in this video. I've done a very extensive deep dive look into each one of the transitions. You can check out those videos. Those are exclusively on the pixelprodisplay.com website. You can find them very quickly by logging into your free PPD membership and jumping in and looking at the search function by typing transition, and all of our videos on transitions will show up. So I wanted to share this with you. The second thing I want to share with you while we're on the screen goes along with exactly how I know what number or time to put into here. So when I was creating this effect in this sequence, I looked at the total duration of the effect, and then I came up here to the timing grid. And one of the nice things is you can physically click, you can see it ends on this timing mark. You can physically click on this part of the grid and say, I want this effect to fade out for this period of time. And so for this song and for this tempo and so forth of this sequence, I realized that clicking and dragging out that at the 1 minute mark, that was about where I wanted it to start doing its transition or fade out in this instance. So you can tell the length of this duration, or your click and drag, by looking over here at your selected area. So this is a nice functionality. If you want to know the best way to put your transitions in, or the best length of time to do your transitions, maybe you only have this much time to do it. So now you can just click and drag. It tells you the number. You go over here and you put the number in to your layers blending box. So that's the second thing I wanted to show you as far as timing goes, things that I really utilize a whole lot in my sequencing. The final thing I want to show you, and you can already see it here up on the top of this screen here, is this red bar line that goes from here to here. Anytime now that you select an effect in X-Lights, you get this red bar guide, and you can already tell how this would be useful when you're laying out a specific effect and you're trying to get this to match the timing grid or the beat of the music using the MP3. You can physically grab and you can move the effect, but I'm not looking right here on the screen. I'm actually looking up here. And now if you pay attention as I drag, you can see that I don't have to have the effect. I don't have to scroll up here and get really close to the timing grid to match up. I can get really, really close to where I want it to be just by looking at where this red line is. Sometimes it's not as easy to get that lineup. And also, let's say you want that effect to be that duration. So it's this duration, but I actually want it to match up with this beat and this beat right here. I can do that. I can grab the whole effect and I can slide it over. And if I have to make an adjustment, I can. But now I know that this is on the offbeat or the upbeat. And I've just taken the same effect and I've given it a different characteristic because I was able to use or utilize the waveform up here with the red line versus just kind of click and drag down here and say, "Dad, did I get it about where I wanted it? And did I measure this out the right way?" Now it's all built into X-Lights with that little red wave guide up at the top. So guys, I hope you folks enjoyed this video. This is definitely something that I use absolutely every day in my sequencing, and there's a lot of functionalities that were added in. I want to share this stuff with you because I know it kind of demystifies X-Lights. Maybe you don't watch the whole video, but I think it's truly important to start exploring some of these functionalities. So like the video if you like, to share it with everybody if you loved it. Remember to subscribe with the big red button down at the bottom. Click the bell notification so you know when we get any new videos posted. You'll be the first to know, and it'll be pushed to your phone, or you'll be let known in Google that we have dropped a video into the channel. Also, folks, don't forget that PPD also offers an awesome sequence club. Every single month, you'll get one sequence included with your PPD club membership, as well as the only membership in the entire hobby that offers vendor discounts where you can save hundreds and thousands of dollars on your pixels, on your Coro props, and also on your controller build. So folks, check out the PPD Sequence Club and save more money with Pixel Pro displays and the vendor affiliates discounts. Thank you for watching. Have an awesome day. Down through the chimney with old Sam. Sam, and every time it rains, it rains.